Your general impressions following an 11-0 victory on Saturday over Manhattan Christian?
Obviously, a lot of good things to take from the game. In games like these, we can start creating a lot of bad habits if we're not careful. And I thought the ladies did a really good job of maintaining possession and working the ball really well. So in games like this, it's always good to for stats and everything like that and to get excited. Obviously, it's good for morale. So pushing the score lineup's okay, doing it the right way.
A dominating offensive performance by your squad for 90 minutes, outshooting the Thunder 59-1. Did you expect so much offensive dominance coming into this affair?
Yeah, I think we're capable of a lot of offense. The big thing that we have going forward this year is a lot of options, and everybody's willing to shoot. And one of the emphasis that we have put on this year is shooting from distance and making sure that we're putting shots on goal. And creating opportunities from that, either via rebounds or shots that hit the crossbar. And we rung the post a couple times today, which was exciting and frustrating. But yeah, I mean, offensively, I think we've got a lot more options this year.
Six different stars found the back of the net on Saturday. Talk about your team's offensive balance shown in this game.
Yeah, I mean, we're a very unselfish team, which is great. We've got a couple of girls that I know were itching to find the back of the net, and it was great to see them. Great for confidence, but we're very unselfish. We don't care who scores or how we score, just that we score, and it's great for the team to see this kind of goal output.
Morgan Lang's 4 goals and 9 total points, each ranked second in a single game in school history. Your thoughts on her accomplishment today?
Yeah, she needed it. I think it was well deserved. Curling in a corner kick from the end line to score is obviously huge, but it's great for confidence. She's one of the players coming in that needed a little bit of a boost on that one. And I mean, her work ethic and her determination to score is it's always there. And to see her rewarded with that kind of performance is huge.
Anya Castelli and Devin Dowell each score their first collegiate goal and only their second collegiate game. Your thoughts on their performances?
There's a reason I was so high in on them in the recruiting process. I know Devin's a very clinical finisher when she needs to be, and her tucking away that PK, it was a no-brainer for me to pick her. And Anya's a workhorse up top. She's going to put a lot of energy into it, and when we can link her up and get her in the play, we're very dangerous. So her finding the back of the net's, again, rewarding to see, and I know her confidence is going to grow.
Your team hits the road for its next upcoming contest. What will be your message to your team in order to help keep them focused following a dominating offensive performance on Saturday?
Just knowing that, Ecclesia College is a different team. We're not stepping on the field against the same squad, and that we have to be prepared for everything. We haven't played Ecclesia for a number of years now, so getting used to seeing them again and putting them back on our schedule was a big thing, and it's the first long road trip of the year. So letting them know that when we step on the field, nothing changes, it's business as usual, and that we need to step up our game. Coming off of a win like this, it's like, you go back to square one, it's 0-0, and the game's even again.